So you are here because you want to learn how to create and use UI packages. You are in the right place. Howdy and welcome. Today I'll show you exactly how to build a UI package with widgets, JavaScript and queries. This guide, it's actually split in two videos. This first one will learn how to create a UI package with multiple widgets, use inputs to pass data and parameters to our package. And on the second video, we'll learn how to use outputs to pass data from our package to the parent app and how to manage versions so your team stays in sync. With that said, let's get started. All right, let's create our first UI package together. We'll go step by step, but at the end, I have a more robust example that showcases how to combine multiple UI packages in an application that can talk to each other and have an actual use case. So make sure to stick to the end. But for now, again, let's go step by step and learn it together. Here I am in my workspace, and let me go to the Create New button dropdown, and there you will see Package. Now we have the new option, UI package, and the option to create a code package, which was the one that we got to encapsulate JavaScript objects and queries. But for now, let's select UI package. And let me tell you, the thing you're going to see here is very similar to building an Appsmith application. You will feel very familiar with it. You have the UI section to define your widgets, your JavaScript section to define your JavaScript objects and your functionality, and the queries to get data from your data sources. So it's nothing different to what you get, but we'll see some different things for make it work in packages. For now, let's just give it a name. I'm going to be calling it users package. Okay. And now packages can also have modules. You might have multiple modules in a single package that contains functionality for a given context. So in this particular case, I'm calling it user packages. So I'm going to be creating a module that I'm going to be calling it user report. But we might have multiple modules around the users package, maybe users cards, user lists, etc. And we can reuse those packages in our applications. Great. Now that we have our package name and our module, let's see the first thing that we start with, which is the module container. And what you can see on the right is the content for it. And we have something called inputs. Input is a simple way to pass data for our package to function properly. So if you need data for this package to maybe make a query database, or maybe have JavaScript logic, or even populate the actual UI elements in the package, that's how you pass data. And inputs are smart because you can pass textual value, or even you can pass complete objects full of data. So that's great. Let me just define one called country, okay? And here we're going to be calling it United States. This is the default value that this input is going to have. Now, that's great because we want to try our package without having to actually embed it on an app. And that's the way we can define the default value. And now let me create another one called limit. And this one is going to be 100. You know what? Let me make it 20. Now, how do we use these inputs? Again, we can use them on the UI components, at the JavaScript object level, or also the query level. Here is where we're going to be using it for now. Let's create a new query, and I have a data source that's connected to my user's database, okay? So if we run it just as it is, we're going to be selecting everything from our user's table and limit it to 10. And there you go, we got data. That's great. But let's use the parameters we got in the package. First thing I'm going to be saying is a where statement, because I want to get the users, which country happens to be what we define in the input. And here's how we use data binding in our query package, which is amazing. All we have to do is just call inputs and the name of the input we want to use. Right now, inputs.country. And also, let's use the limit input value that we define to define the limit of this particular query. So now, if we run this query again, now we're going to get the users, which country happens to be United States. There you go, country is United States, and a limit of 20 records. Here you go, 20 records. That's great. Now, as you can see, we're using the inputs we got in our package in our query layer. Again, we can use it in JavaScript and also in the UI level. We're gonna be using that soon. For now, let's also rename this query, and I'm gonna be calling it get users. by country. There you go. Now let's go back to the UI and let's drag and drop our first widget into this package. And let's connect this to our, let me just make it a little bit bigger. There you go. To our get users by query that we just created. And there you go. Now it's populating with the data from the query that uses the inputs that we define in our module container. That is great. Now we just notice how easy it is to define inputs, create our first UI widget in the package, define a module that uses a query to populate data in our query. Now let's publish this first version that we got of our UI package. And there you go, it's created. Now let's go back to our workspace and let's create an application. This application is going to be having the implementation of this particular package and other packages we'll create soon, okay? So to be prepared for it, let me just create a container, okay? And in this container, I'm going to be defining some functionality that I'm going to be using for the package. Since we define a way to pass countries and limits to our package, we need to define a UI to control that. So let me just bring a select drop down here. And let me have the countries that I want to filter by. I have United States, Norway, Australia, Brazil, etc. And the default value is going to be United States as well. And let me just call this country. That's the label of our dropdown. There you go. Perfect. And now let me bring another one, an input. And this input is going to be a number input. The default value is going to be 100. The label is going to be limit. And we can have some validation on it. Like, for example, the minimum and maximum value. Let's define the mix and max. And there you go. One other thing we can use as well is define a name. I'm going to be calling it country top dropdown. And this one I'm going to be calling it limit. There you go. Now let's go to the UI section. And now you will see a new tab on the list of widgets. We have the standard widgets and now we have the modules. Here we have our users package and the user report module inside that user package. So let's drag and drop this thing over here. And now you will see that it's going to be populated with the default values of the package. But let's use, again, data binding to pass the data from our drop-down section or filter section to the package in order to function properly the way we want it. So the limit is going to be the name of the input, which remember we call it limit, and the property that text. And for the country, we're going to be using the country dropdown that selected option value. There you go. So now we should be getting 100 records, which happens to have the United States as their country. We got 73 records because we don't have enough to get 100. But if we change this to maybe two, we're going to be getting the first two records, which happens to be United States. Now we can filter by Australia. And again, as soon as the data changes in our dropdown, that's going to be passing to our package. And since our package is listening to changes in the inputs, it's going to be refreshing the data for that particular change. And as you can see, in a few minutes, we got a reusable UI package that's able to be reused across applications, which can define different ways to pass data for it to function in using the beautifulness of the data binding, which happens to have from the parent app to the package and inside the package to the queries and the JavaScript objects and the UI elements. That's brilliant. And that's it. Now you have a reusable UI component that works across all of your applications. If you want to try UI packages yourself, sign up for an Appsmith Business Edition now using the link in the description. You got questions? Drop them in the comments. I'll see you on the next one.